What's up, guys? Back with another video, and today we are playing some NBA 2K23. So, yeah, we are back after we got our Summer League Championship win. And then he started, like, bro, like I started trash talking. What's up, NBA? Okay, stop at the gym. I was head to Brooklyn's gym. I'm 60 overall, okay. Hey,
how you doing?
MP, nice to meet you.
Oh, you know my name.
It would be weird if I didn't.
Yeah, that's a good point.
You're right on time for your meeting with Mr. Novak. Elevator's over there.
Cool. Yeah, thank you so much.
Olive.
Olive, wow, that's a nice name. It's a pleasure to meet you, Olive.
Nice to meet you, too. Welcome to the team.
Thank you.
Okay.
MP, it's great to finally meet you.
Pleasure's all mine, man. Hey, I read the article about you in the Pen Down. You're one data-obsessed cat, man.
Well, you can never have too much data. I'm glad you came. Look, this Shep thing, it's not going anywhere anytime soon. We're going to need to put in some work to make sure it doesn't have a negative impact in the start of your career.
Yeah, so just like work hard, play well, make people forget Shep ever existed.
Yes and no. Let's say we put you in the starting lineup tomorrow and you stumble a little bit. Normally, no big deal. But 68% of our fans wanted Shep, and of that 68%, 95% have a highly unfavorable opinion of him.
Okay, so that's basically corporate speak for they hate my guts.
Correct. Which means it becomes a story. Papers in this town are out for blood. I'm sure you saw the top take segment.
Oh, I did.
Okay, look. There's no reason to think that you're not going to take off right out of the gate. But any hiccup in your play, and we've got a distraction on our hands. It's bad for your growth, bad for team chemistry, and it makes Phil Boyer look bad. He stuck his neck out for you on draft night.
Okay, so what's the solution?
Glad you asked. We identify key influencers in our biggest target demos, and we develop strategy to win their affections.
Wait, so you're telling me my playing time is dependent on what? Whether Johnny TikTok thinks I'm base or something like that?
I know, it's ridiculous. But everything's connected. If we don't deal with this in a holistic manner, it could affect the bottom line. And when the bottom line's affected, the governors aren't happy. When the governors aren't happy, nobody's happy.
Okay. I just want to be a pillar in this community, man. So if we can find a way to make this, you know, Win the City initiative be a part of that, I'm sold. But I also don't want to do a bunch of PR fluff, though.
Same page, 100%. Look, I've already talked with your whole team about this impressive group of people, by the way, and they're going to take a lead on it, okay? But my door is always open.
Freddie, man, I appreciate your transparency, man. Truly.
Just doing my job. Believe me, it is an honor to work with someone as talented as you. I'm really looking forward to seeing what we can accomplish together.
Okay.
Those kicks, MP.
Oh, you want to try
What up, kid?
What's going on? Yo, I appreciate you being here, but like I said, you gotta do this.
What? This is the in-person treatment that you hired me for. Look, just remember this day when Barry and Associates shows up, trying to see if you need a new agent, all right?
Alright, yo, fair enough, man. So where do we start, man? Let's go on this little tour.
Well, are you ready, Sire?
Don't do that. Cut the little butler act, man. Act normal, bro.
Yeah, that didn't even feel right.
Alright,
but check it out. First up, we have the only runway in the world that can compete with Paris Fashion Week.
Yeah, bro, that looks like a pretty normal hallway.
Yeah, to the untrained eye, it's a normal hallway. But we both know that them pregame walks have made fashion icons out of Russell Westbrook, SGA, LeBron James. I mean, the branding possibilities are endless, man.
All right, I see you.
Now, look, once you get some shine on the court, you know, getting your fashion bag, photographers gonna be all over you, bro. And the best part is, all you gotta do is show up ready to work, look and fly.
Come on, and I can do that, can't I?
Yeah, maybe with a little bit of help you can. Sure.
I get fly to you.
It don't even matter. Right now, I just want you to focus on your game, all right? Fashion can come later. All right, so check this out. Down this way, you got the press room. Now, anytime you got some post-game media availability, this is where you're going to want to go.
Okay.
Now, Ashley will meet you tonight after the game to walk you over, you know, give you some more pointers, but typically it's going to be on you to make sure you don't miss these opportunities. I mean, opening yourself up more for the press is just better for you. I mean, but you're a natural-born leader. You get that.
Bro, I do this, man. I could do media in my sleep.
All right,
you know this.
Well, one more note on that. The media is allowed all through this hallway, so you might get stopped for press time just when you're walking around. And because I said that, you are under the microscope here, all right?
Oh, you gotta
act accordingly. That's all I'm saying.
You ain't gotta make it sound so intense, man. I got this.
All right.
What else you got for me?
All right, well, down here is also the arena manager's office. You're probably not gonna go there much, but, you know, just so you know. And also, there's your standard, generic meeting room. Now, once again, you're probably not gonna use it much, but, I mean, could come in handy if you need to have a private conversation.
Right, right. Away from the prying eyes of the tabloids, right?
Yes, look at you paying attention. I like that.
A little bit, man.
And then down further a little bit this way, you've got the locker room. And looks like Coach Graves is waiting for you, actually.
Okay. Anything else?
That's it. Now, I gotta shake some hands before tonight's game, but you go out there and have fun, man.
Appreciate it, man. Again, man, it's always good seeing a familiar face in new settings.
Man, don't even mention it. That's what I'm here for. Have a great game, man.
All right, man.
Here nice and early. Love to see it.
Just doing my job, Coach.
Humble and hardworking. With qualities like to see in a draft pick. But you already knew that.
Okay.
Let me show you the locker room.
Let's do it.
Yeah. I thought I'm trying to do
one of these before. Nothing too unusual. Your locker's over there.
The one with my name on it, right?
Quick study. We put the starter's name on the whiteboard over here before every game. Coach likes to keep things regular, but obviously injuries happen. People perform or they don't, so it'll change from time to time.
Right. Hopefully it changes sooner rather than later.
You're doing the right things. You'll be there sooner than you think.
Hey, that's the plan.
Come on, let me show you my office. Come on. Now, I know you're anxious to find out how you're going to fit into the rotation.
Coach, man, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't hyped. You got no idea.
Like I said, we wanted to see how you performed under pressure, so we put a lot of weight in your performance in the Summer League Championship.
Yeah, you were very clear about that.
Good. So, we got together and talked about it, and decided the best role for you to start the year is as a solid rotation player off the bench. We'll get you the minutes. It's up to you to make the most of them.
That's not exactly what I was expecting, but I guess it's up to me to earn my way into the starting lineup.
And you've got the potential to get there. But I don't want you focusing on that right now. Take it one day at a time, put in the work, and the results will follow.
I've never been afraid of the work, you know? It's just I expect more from myself than this in the long term.
I get it, 100%. Honestly, I'd be concerned if you didn't feel that way. You want to make it here, you got to have a hunger to be the best.
I mean, if you're not competing to be the best here, what are we doing?
Exactly. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. If you want to get dressed, you know where your locker is, and once you're ready to head to the court, it's a tunnel across from the locker room. Any questions?
Coach, yeah, I'm ready. Let's get it.
See you out there.
Girl. Damn.
Opening day is here. So, what are these players right now, Greg, feeling as they kick off this brand new season?
I thought we were gonna Lakers first, but oh, this is cool. Okay. Okay. Oh, Lakers are up. Seriously, I gotta match up with a Jaw. Oh my goodness.
In terms of entertainment factor, can any current player top Ja Morant? I mean, we've seen Ja with some vicious in-game throwdowns. Here's MP. And just miss after miss right now.
Don't go back for a shot. Shut up, buddy.
Brooks against Barrett. Here's Morant. And Morant throws it down.
Come on, why am I feeding this off Morant?
Lead guard position. Morant there just stuffs it. Hey, Craig, talking about the great Ja Morant, this guy is just flat out fun to watch. Well, Ja's been known to go off for 50 on any given night, but he also looks dropping some nasty dimes. Morant has an insane combination of athleticism and skill. This guy can do anything. Jackson, a screen on MP. Outside for Jackson. And the three off target. Knicks trail by three. MP passes to Toppin. Back to MP. And he's fouled. He's fouled. For proof of what Morant's done for the Memphis franchise, look at the offensive numbers. Grizzlies have made huge steps forward every year. No good on the second.
Oh my. That was so good.
Morant has been very steady. And the Grizzlies went from the 20th rated offense in his rookie season to number 16 in his second year. And then all the way to number 5 last season, Ja has turned them into a powerhouse. The D just kind of stepping aside and letting him get to the rim. There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
I'll tell you, you can't get stops if you're unwilling to put in the work.
With the fadeaway. That shot, no good. And New York the other way now. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Memphis.
Should be an interesting game as these teams don't see a lot of each other being from different conferences.
Right. They'll meet two times this year, East versus West. Let's see which team can enforce their style of play.
3 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Jones kicks to Bane. On the pass to Conchar. There's the screen. Outside, Jones. Shot clock at 6. Doesn't get it to drop for him. MP looking around. Not off in time. And the last shot at the buzzer doesn't get him.
Nice. My God. What's up?
That one misses for Barrett. Doris, since 2000, the New York Knicks have won a grand total of one playoff series. What are their issues? Why the problems?
Yeah, I think, Kevin, you always evaluate an organization in its totality. You start with the ownership group, then you go to the general manager, down to the coaches, and how is your roster? What caliber of player is there? Clearly, they have not had stability amongst the GMs, the coaches, or the personnel. It does, however, appear that they are moving in a direction with a clear plan now.
We've got Tyus Jones. Jackson is out there with Desmond Bain. Then there's John Morant. And it's Tillman in at the five. That's the lineup out there for the Grizzlies. MP, no good.
How was that a bad shot?
And so it's Bain with it. He'll bring it up for the Grizzlies. They trail by six. Jackson misses.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession. And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Brunson against Morant. Jackson setting the pick here for Bane. Outside for Jackson. And another miss by Memphis. The Knicks leading by six. Outside. He dishes it to MP. And blocked. That one goes careening off the glass.
No, sir. Jackson Jr.'s shot blocking abilities. Part of why he was a top five pick back in 18.
Jones, no one around him. Good and nice assist. Morant's got three assists in the game. The Knicks have gone 5-12 from the field here in the second. Barrett, no good.
Well, he's got to be embarrassed for attempting that one. You got to think twice about that next time.
8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
Yeah, that's fire right there. Morant practicing for the dunk contest. I see you, young fella.
And that last look brought to you by the AT&T 5G Slam King. Pass to Brunson. Pass to Randall. MP right side.
And superb job on Morant there, making sure to contest.
And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Knicks lead by one. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute.
Thanks for stopping by, y'all. First up on the show tonight, a quick look ahead of some upcoming games on the docket.
For that game against the Pistons, should be a fascinating one. Going against the best team in the league is a daunting task. But I think they're pumped. They want to prove they can play with anyone.
So let's move on now to this Grizzlies game, which has turned out to be a tight one.
They're falling behind because they're missing from the outside. I think they need to find a new recipe, one that doesn't rely on the three ball.
Yeah, that would be insanity, doing the same thing and expecting a different result. You know what they got to do, big fella? They got to feed the post. They got to get it into that big fella who stands there like a sequoia.
Sequoia is a fish, right, Ernie?
That'll do it for our show tonight. Thanks for joining us, and we'll send you back to Kevin Harlan for more Hoops action.
And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. You have to like what you're seeing from John Morant.
And the way he goes at defender.
At the line for Memphis, Tyus Jones. At the line for one,
But why am I facing a 6-year-old?
And that one falls for Jones. When you think of backcourt offenses in general, Greg, how critical is ball and player movement to a team's success?
Kevin, unless you have incredible isolation scores, it's essential. Even then, keeping the defense rotating and reacting is the best way to create open looks and offensive rebound opportunities.
Setting the floor for the Knicks. They've got Toppin. Rose is out there with MP. And it's Grimes in at the three, the small forward.
Spacing the floor. Brooks is comfortable shooting it from deep.
And there's a minute 45 left in the third quarter of the game. There's MP. It's rebounded by Memphis. They can look forward to the Rockets Arena after this matchup to take on Houston. And that'll be the first of a two-game road trip for them. Unloads from nine. And the basket by Jones. Now it's a seven-point Grizzly lead.
To their advantage, trying to find a way to blow this one open.
One of the things they're doing is identifying favorable matchups and then going at them.
A good point there, Kevin, but overall they're getting slightly out rebounded.
104 left in the third quarter. Brooks the pass to Clark. And slam dunk by Clark.
And really, this is the time.
Or that they just have a few more possessions like that.
Here's Rose. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. To the wing right side. Pass to MP. Shot to stop the run. And he could not.
Bro, let me just...
history. Think back to the championship team of the 70s. Walt Clyde Frazier. Then the Patrick Ewing era.
Go so fast.
They have had so many Hall of Famers.
Puts it up from 12. And the Grizzlies take on two more.
Hit him in the face. Whooping.
The drive by MP. Another shot. And blocked by Bane. The shot and game clock separated by four. He takes it in. Here's Conshaw.
Make of that. Oh my.
MP against Bane. Now here's MP. The pass to Grimes. Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits. It.
Yep, we're done. We like
17. 131
like over 20 points to win the game. Like 17.
Back to Jones. Unloads from 13. That drops and it comes off an assist from Brooks. Brooks has got his third assist on the night. Knicks trail by 19.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for the Grizzlies.
Two great rebounding teams.
And these guys worked just a little bit harder tonight, and that was the edge they needed.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year.
And so they'll take the first game of the season series, a team they'll only see twice
they're certainly happy to start it off with a win.
And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for John Morant.
This guy putting on a passing clinic. If you want to know how to run an offense, roll back the tape from this evening.
They've got Jones. Brooks is out there with Brandon Clark. And it's Conshaw into the two. That's the lineup out there for the Grizzlies.
Attacking in transition, the most consistent way to generate easy looks.
The very definition of quality transition offense. If it can end at the cup, it's exactly where you want it.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
Yeah, playing with great energy and great effort. And as a coach, you'd love to see this from your team every single night.
Oh, what an impressive dribble drive. That replay brought to you by Mobile One.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
What?
At the line for Memphis, Billy Brooks.
I wasn't a game at all.
For you, or he can be a high usage guy. It really depends on what a team needs from night to night.
5 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. And that falls.
And giving up some inches inside that makes up for it.
Your Grizzlies, 87. The Knicks, 69.
Oh, Lord. Jason made another one.
Please exit the building carefully, and we hope we'll see you again soon.
Oh, Lord. Jason made another one.
No, not a good match. Still, I'm right though.
Hey, MP, you need the press room.
Can I get a hey, MP? How was the game? You look really good out there. How are you feeling out there?
Hey, how are you feeling? Also, you're needed in the press room.
Okay, so we can just skip the small talk then.
I'm going to give you a rundown of the situation. We don't have much time, so I need you to listen closely because I will not be repeating myself.
Okay, I'm all ears.
Obviously, they're going to want to ask questions about how you played, so if you feel like you underperformed at all, you're going to want to call on John Luck. Because his whole thing is access, so he's bound to lob you a softball or two. If you're feeling confident, you're going to want to call on Nate White, the man fans love to hate. His number one goal is to stir up controversies, so if you messed up even a little bit, he's going to be all over that. Also, he's going to have a couple Shep questions to throw your way, so if you want to get into that, then he's your guy. The other major player on the beat is Candace Green. She's not here today, but she likes to get into the longer view of things, really get into the X's and O's, so if you want to brag about your basketball IQ, she is your person to call on.
Okay. All right. Hey, is there someone that you would choose first if you were me? Is there a conversation I should stay away from, you know?
That is completely up to you.
Yeah.
What you say in that room is going to go a long way in establishing your identity as a leader and your personal brand.
Okay.
And though I might have ideas about what you should say in a given situation, I can't tell you who to be.
Yeah.
Now, that doesn't mean you should go starting any giant PR nightmares,
no,
okay?
No, no, no.
But there is more than one way to skin the proverbial cat, if you follow me.
Yeah, for sure. Any more advice? Yeah.
Lots, but you're needed inside. Go.
Yeah. We're here.
They are indeed. All right, look, I just gave you a lot of information in a short amount of time. And what I want you to know is that what drew me to you as a potential employer was your grace under pressure. Just always really respected the way that you handle yourself in the press, and I think you're gonna do a fantastic job in there.
Wow, you really fought through that one. But thank you. It's probably one of the nicest things you said to me. All right.
You really need to get in there. They get cranky if they think they're going to miss deadlines.
I got you. I'm in there.
Got it. Let's go.
Hey, everyone. All right, man, you up first right here.
I mean, I don't want to be an instigator, but it's got a sting coming out so flat in your NBA debut. What do you wish you could have done differently?
I can see the kind of reporter that you're going to be. I wish we could have got the win.
Yeah, I mean, okay, right. That's a political good answer, but I mean, you personally, what could you have done differently to get a win?
Make shots, get stops. I mean, it's a make or miss league, Nate. I mean, they made more shots than tonight, so they got the win. We just got to cash in on our opportunities next time, and we'll be all right. Okay, next question. John.
There were a lot of media outlets in the preseason that made a big deal about the fan base's so-called negative reaction to you on draft day. But I did see quite a few people in the stands supporting you. Could you speak a little bit about that?
Yeah, John, you know, I felt that support tonight, and it was love. You know, I can't complain about that. But I think with the whole, you know, Shep controversy was a bit of a, like, media creation, you know, if we're being honest here. Now, don't get me wrong, you know, it's not like I feel like I should be handed the keys to the city or, you know, get the red carpet rolled out for me. But these days, it feels like everyone has an opinion, you know, so you can always find someone that's willing to put you down if you look for it. You know, it's there. You know, for me, I'm just more focused on the people that support me, genuinely. You know, and I've got plenty of support in the city, so it feels good.
Times we live in, right? Thanks, MP.
Yeah, no problem, man. Good question, by the way. All right, that's it for today. Till the next time, y'all.
Head back to the office when you get a chance. Okay, so that was not a good win.
Must be looking forward to the next one.
Okay, I will let him know.
What up, Rick? You good?
Hey, yeah, just got off the phone with Othello Ockham's assistant, and the big boss man wants to see you.
What about? I mean, he's not one of those super hands-on GMs, is he?
Nah, I mean, that's not really his reputation.
So,
honestly, I don't know what this is about, man. I mean, I tried to press his assistant for some more info, but all he told me was that Coach Graves will be there, too.
Okay. Something about this feels off.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I agree.
You got any advice?
Go in there with an open mind, see what they want to talk about, and come back here and we'll talk about it.
Bet.
so much running. Sound effects.
Hey, Olive.
MP, how are you?
Well, I can't complain. A little nervous, but I can't complain.
It looks like you're with Mr. Acton today.
Yeah. Where is he again?
Same floor as Mr. Novak.
Okay. You got any advice for me?
On talking to Mr. Acton?
Yeah, well, you've been working here for some time, you know.
I don't really know him like that. But you're a smart guy. I'm sure you're gonna be fine.
How do you know I'm a smart guy, though?
I can read people, and you're smart.
Thank you, but okay. So, what number am I thinking of right now?
I said I could read people. I'm not psychic.
It's kind of the same difference, a little bit.
Yeah, it's a little different. Aren't you gonna be late for your meeting?
Yeah, I probably will be. Same elevator as usual.
Yes, they haven't moved.
Yeah, right. Okay. Well, it's nice chatting with you. I'll see you later.
Good luck.
MP, come on in, take a seat.
What's up, MP?
Coach Graves, Mr. Ockpim.
What'd I tell you about that? Othello, please.
I'm in my bag, you got it.
So, about Shep.
Oh, you too.
Now just listen. We knew the PR hit we'd take for picking you over him. But that's all just outside noise. Inside these walls, all we care about is ball.
All right, well, I'm willing to put in the work. On and off the court, so whatever it takes. I actually spoke to Freddie Novak.
Talked to Freddie?
Did I do something wrong by talking to Freddie?
Freddie's a nice guy. I like him. But all this stuff about controlling your own narrative, you're a ball player, not a politician.
We put together a very specific game plan for you. You hit these goals, you're in the starting lineup. Simple as that.
Okay, Freddie made it seem like I had to do a bunch of PR stuff just to get my shot with the stars.
That's flat out wrong. This Shep stuff has nothing, I repeat, nothing to do with your playing time. I want you to focus on your craft, not this PR stuff. Am I clear?
Crystal clear.
Good. I don't need to keep you. But if you ever want to talk, or if Freddie gives you a hard time, whatever. My door is always open.
Thank you, Mr. Ockpim.
Othello. Don't mention it. Thank me by putting in the work.
See you, Coach.
Sounds good, Jerry. Yeah. Yeah, I'll link up with you later, man. All right, have a great one.
Yo, you want me to come back?
No, you good.
You sure?
Yeah, I just wanted to talk with you about your meeting with Othello.
To be honest with you, man, I'm a little confused.
Yeah, I thought you might say that.
Yeah. So you know something?
Man, I'm all over it.
So what's your take on it then, man? And one ear, I got Freddy tell me one thing, and the other, I have Othello basically forbidding me to talk to Freddy.
Oh, well, he forbid you?
Well, not exactly, but he's not happy that I'm talking to him. I mean, the thing is, you know, winning over the fans, I'm all for. It is my thing, it's a great idea, it's well-researched. But Rick, man, if it's me stepping on people's toes, I'm not for it. Like, I don't want to make the coaching staff angry.
That's not gonna happen, all right?
So what's the plan, man?
Well, first of all, relax. All right, everything's fine, man, it's just a little palace intrigue. That's all.
Palace intrigue? All right, sure.
Look, your president of basketball ops, Phil Boyer, he's feeling the heat right now. He underestimated the PR hit that he would take by drafting you while Shep is still on the board. And optics, for better or worse, are very important for a man in his position.
Yeah, I mean, he's got a career to consider, so I get it.
Okay, so if you take this whole thing seriously, it'll do a great deal of getting you ahead.
Okay. Well, like I said, I'm down for whatever. Just say the word.
All right, that's good, that's good. But meanwhile, you still got Othello Akpim thinking that Freddy's some existential threat.
A threat? Is he, like, angling for a job? Dude is in marketing, man.
I don't know. Stranger things have happened. Wow.
I don't know. Dude seemed pretty straightforward to me.
I mean, that was my read, too, but... I mean, I don't mean Othello's not worried. Look, the way he sees it, Phil's legacy is tied to him, which means that Freddy's got his ear because you come with a lot of media baggage.
Okay, again, that part makes sense.
Okay, plus you got the whole data-driven angle. You gotta remember, Othello's old school, like a real scouts and chalkboard style. Thinks that anybody with a computer's trying to push him out the league.
Right.
All right, so all I'm saying is you gotta walk a real fine line here, man. I mean, goes without saying, you have to perform.
Yo, the funny thing is, that does not seem to be the focus right now, at all.
Like, I mean, you want the money, right?
Hey.
Then this all comes with it.
Hey, I ain't complaining. I just think it's funny, man.
Look, all this means is that we gotta be delicate, all right? So instead of launching this, you know, full-on PR blitz, probably on the lines of what Freddie would want, let's dip our toes in this whole plan to win over the fans.
I see what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
You want a slow play.
Slow play, oh, exactly.
All right.
It's not like we won't do nothing. We'll just ease into it. Keep Othello and Freddie happy, which keeps Phil happy.
Okay.
Which makes us one big, happy, slightly dysfunctional family.
Okay. It's all making sense now. So when we start, man?
Well, Mila and Ashley are running point on it, so I'm sure they'll hit you up when they got something to say.
Yo, let them know whenever, wherever, it don't matter. I'm there, I'm your guy.
Okay, I get it. Look, in the meantime, you just focus on ball, all right? Hit the goals that Othello and Coach G gave you, win some games maybe, and we're gonna be golden.
Win some games?
I'm just saying.
Hey, that ain't no issue.
Yeah, I didn't think it was gonna be.
All right, then.
All right, get out there, man.
Okay, let's do this. Do this, boys. We got this.
Team is starting out slower than anticipated. How do you prevent frustration from setting in, Grant?
That's a tough one.
Setting the floor for the Pistons. Bay, the small forward, with Bagley holding down the four. Alec Burks is out there with Hayes. And it's Duren in at the center position. Back to Hayes. Here's Duren. Really played well against Orlando in his last game. And he was camped in the lane there. He gets a 3-second call.
Those kinds of mistakes.
1:21 left in the opening quarter. Rose against Hayes. Rose, the pass to MP. Talking about MP, what a college career he had. Just fantastic in school, a star on many levels.
MP playing 3 years before coming to the NBA. That is rare these days, but I think it was great for his overall development. Of course, it helps winning a title in school.
Clock at 6. Burks for 3. Hartenstein pulls it in.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them.
MP, the pass to Toppin. Here's MP. It's deflected.
Yeah, anytime you put the ball up near Durant, there's a chance it ends up back in your face.
MP's shot is good.
And despite the size mismatch, getting a little aggressive down there in the paint.
Proving once again that when you attack with confidence, good things tend to happen.
And he's able to get it back. Yep, count it. New York trailing. Stolen by Burks. Outside Bagley. Takes the 3. And that one makes him 2 for 2. He's in his rhythm.
Boy, oh boy. Both teams lighting it up to start this game.
And you wonder how long they can keep it going. At some point, you expect the defense will adjust.
Back to Rose. Shoots over Burks. Oh, he got it up in. Set to bring you quarter number 2 after this. Hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far. Halfway through the first half in this one. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The hustle stats for the Pistons.
For me, they're turning defense into offense. Creating opportunities by taking the ball away. Great effort.
And how about their shot blocking tonight? I mean, creating doubt every time the ball goes up. But they're there lurking.
Setting the floor for the Pistons. It's Cunningham and Ivy at the 1 and the 2. Bojan Bogdanovic out there with Isaiah Stewart. And it's Bagley in at the 5, down low. Yep, that one's good.
I love the skill level of Cade Cunningham. He has every shot in the book.
Fantastic replay we just saw of the Mobile One drive.
Yeah, staying with it and looking to expand this margin. Hard-nosed takes like that will certainly help.
Pass to MP. Baseline jumper. The shot no good. And Detroit will go the other way with it. First chance of the season for them to go up against this Knicks team.
They really struggled against this team last year, despite having comparable talent. I mean, they got swept in the season series.
Now Bagley. And here's Cunningham. Just 4 to shoot. Here's Ivy. Off target. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. Don't grant Ivy gets a lot of attention for his scoring, but he can also lock you down at the other end.
Oh, yes, he can, B.A. He's big, active, and athletic, too. A strong on-ball defender as well. He'll also jump passing lanes, causing deflections. He looks to flip turnovers into points.
Pass to Cunningham from downtown. It's rebounded by New York. Last game matched up with the Grizzlies. A tough loss there.
In today's NBA, you have to stretch the floor or you're going to struggle big time.
The reason why, that opens up driving lanes, makes it dangerous for teams to double you in the post. The offense becomes more dynamic.
Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Well, guys, the Pistons focusing on improving their scoring. Coach Dwayne Casey said, quote, "This is an offensive league. In today's game, you've got to be able to shoot the 3 because you can't make enough 2s to win. It's tough to defend the 3, so you've got to keep that scoreboard moving." Back to you.
Floor spacing at a premium, Allie. Thank you.
You have to like the composure that MP had to get that finish inside.
Pass to Bogdanovic. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second. Basket counts. Bogdanovic has got 8.
Defensively, they've got to get more bodies in the paint. That's 3 straight field goals from below the free throw line.
Here's Toppin. Outside Barrett. Toppin, a screen on Bogdanovich. Barrett passes to Toppin. Back to Barrett. New York needs to get one up quick. The timer ticks. Over Bagley. And there's Barrett on the assist by Randle.
Terrific.
Through the first half of play here in what's been a good one.
Welcome one and all. Before we hear Kenny and Shaq's insights on that first half, let's look ahead and check out the upcoming schedule. And Kenny, were there any specific teams you looked forward to playing?
I mean, any team Shaq was on, because you had to be hyped for that, you know, especially when you got a team and they go head to head. I always look forward to that.
Yeah, you look.
And we return our attention to tonight's featured game as the Knicks had a closely contested first half.
They were sloppy, gave the ball away too much. And that comes down to one thing, for KISS.
Oh. Thanks for joining us. Time to head back over to the...
And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. Julius Randle has been sensational.
He's been so disruptive defensively.
A lot of coaches make the transition from college to the NBA. Smitty, what are the biggest challenges in making that leap, you think?
I think gaining trust from your players is totally different from the NBA and college. Also, the pace of the game. Not the speed of the players, but the flow of gameplay itself. And finding the soft spot in an NBA defense is much harder than it is in college.
And forward, it's Barrett and Randle. MP is out there with Emmanuel quickly. And it's Toppin in at the five. So that's who's on the floor for the Knicks. Cunningham, right side. There's the triple. Randle pulls down the board. Randle's got five rebounds tonight.
The will is there, but the execution is lacking. He can't seem to finish plays this quarter.
Here's MP. The rebound by Stewart.
Oh, what a dream.
Stewart's got seven rebounds in the game. Cunningham, left side. It's rebounded by New York. Barrett's got four rebounds now.
And in Jaden Ivey and Jalen Duren, the Pistons taking arguably the two best athletes in the 22 draft. The youth movement is on, and Detroit is definitely fun to watch.
Toppin passes to MP. This for the tie! Again, MP missing.
At some point, when you recognize someone's this out of rhythm, you have to shift to something else.
Bogdanovich, that's good. Bogdanovich has got 10 points in the game.
Has a great combination of height and body frame. Bogdanovich can keep up with the defenders physically.
And we just had to see that mobile one drive one more time. Great stuff.
Yeah, B.A., I mean, that's such a play here in a close game like this one. Great concentration from him.
And the Knicks making a change here. Rose has checked in. 1:56 left in the third quarter. Bogdanovich passes to Hayes. Drops in the three. Hayes has got his second basket of the game.
And his teammates appreciate the unselfishness. Bogdanovich willing to get it to his open guys.
Pass to MP. The baseline J is on the way. Rebound Detroit. Hayes got four rebounds in the game. And here's Hayes.
Oh.
Let's a floater go, and the shot goes in. And it's a 10-point Pistons lead.
They're really settling into a nice rhythm now, starting to gain the upper hand.
They're playing well. They're building momentum. This is how they can turn a small lead into a big one.
I know he's on a cold streak, but he can't let that get in his head.
And his rhythm has been way off. The goal now might be to get him something easy at the rim so he can just see the ball go in through the net, and that helps.
Pass to Randle. Back to MP. Shot to stop the run. The offensive rebound. And it's Randle with the jam.
Have to block out Randle. He's an absolute beast on the offensive boards.
Detroit has gone just 1 of 6 from long distance here in the third. The shots just aren't falling. Here's Hayes. The shot off that time. New York goes the other way with it. Following this game, they host the Magic. It'll be the second of 3 straight games on their home floor. Pass to Toppin. On the wing, MP takes a 3. Oh, another miss by MP.
Something's off about him this quarter.
And it also shows you how difficult this game is.
That one misses. Up at the power forward spot, Graham.
You know, B.A., that power forward spot might be his best position. Not the quick twitch type of athlete, but great physicality for a perimeter player.
Setting the floor for the Pistons. Hayes is out there with Kate Cunningham. Then there's Bojan Bogdanovic. Then it's Duren. And it's Burks in at the 3, small forward. It's tipped!
Oh, the length of Cunningham. A New York ball.
And for Cunningham. Sadiq Bey. Seconds left in the fourth quarter. 5 on the clock. Pass to MP. And a bit of a battle for the ball. And the official signal. Hayes, the pass to Bay. Now here's Bogdanovic. And here's Hayes. Back to Bogdanovic. 4 on the clock. They set the pick. Oh, and that's going to be too many steps. Gets the whistle on the travel.
Pistons substitution. Marvin Bagley III. Isaiah Stewart.
5 ticks left in the final quarter. Pass to Sims. Kicks it out to MP. So it's Detroit easily grabbing this one.
That's the end of the ball game.